championship game featuring the Mission Black Ice looking for their second Pama Pro Championship and the Underdogs Team Rink Rat. Chris Treft alongside Downtown George Brown. Downtown, this is going to be an excellent matchup, a very talented Rink Rat team. They have an excellent goaltender in Tartaglione who got them here, but they're going up against a juggernaut in Mission Black Ice.
Listen, we all know about Mission Black Ice. They've been a powerhouse for the last few years in the sport of roller hockey, but what we don't know is about Rink Rat, because Rink Rat is one of those teams that they depend on their goaltender, because I'll tell you one thing, out there in the semifinal, it was nobody but Tommy Tartaglione who stole that game. They have scores. We know about Junior Cadiz. We know about Matt Berry, Garrett Ross, Joaquin Chavera, Ethan Chavera. We know about all those names. Cal O'Reilly. We know about everybody. But the guy that stole the game was Tommy Tartaglione, so he's going to have to come up big again. Can he do it a second time in the playoffs?
Rink Rat has a very deep roster. A lot of first-timers here in the Pama Pro Championship Final. George, it's time to meet Team Rink Rat. Well, there you have it, Team Rink Rat. They're looking for an upset. They've had a phenomenal tournament so far. A lot of names you know, a few names you don't. So expect big things from them here tonight. And then you got Mission Black Ice. We're going to show you the players of Mission Black Ice, but you pretty much already know them, right?
Yeah, you should know everybody on this team. Without a doubt, this is a first-class sport, a first-class organization. When you think about champions over the past few years, you can't say anybody else's name other than Snipers or Black Ice. And with the Snipers being out, Black Ice comes in as a heavy favorite. But how do they handle that today? How good are they with the pressure on them, because everybody expects them to win? Rink Rat's a Cinderella story. Rink Rat's not supposed to win today. No. They've got the talent to win, but they're not supposed to. Black Ice has all the pressure on them. So we know all the names, like you said before, and those are the ones that are supposed to perform. The biggest name in the game in big time games is John Schaubel. But Tyler Craft has just turned into an all-world player.
The leading scorer of this tournament.
Yes, and he continues to bring it. Being on the bench with Black Ice, he's just not leading by example, but he's one of the most vocal leaders, and he's so positive. And this guy, the way Jason Miro and Aaron Rice run that bench, it exudes through every single player. And as long as they play their game, nobody's beating them.
Keys to success for Rink Rat. First off is stay out of the box. That
power play
for Black Ice. We always joke, what are the numbers? What would it be? But I'm sure if you look at the numbers, they're probably 90 to 95%.
Yeah, and the one thing you got to think about, they get a box set up. It's more like a trapezoid. Yeah. And John Schiavo and KJ Tickenworth are always low. And then up high, it's always PJ DiMartino and Tyler Craft. The one thing is, and I talked about this even during my game, Andy Ferentino came to me and said, what do I do? I didn't have an answer. And it's because of the fact that you can press Tyler Craft, and then he's going to dish it to Schiavo, and he's great at that backdoor shot at a tough angle. Or Craft can just snipe. And one thing we haven't even seen is DiMartino or Tiefenworth snipe on that side. Everything's been on the left side. So their power play is so dangerous. You're right. Stay out of the box.
And for Rink Rat, I mean, it's not only staying out of the box, but you got to capitalize on your chances and not turn the puck over.
And you're not going to get many of them. But against this team, you don't have to play a perfect game against any other team. Other teams you can get away with, and you'll get a get-out-of-jail-free card a couple times after your pass go. Against this team, you don't get any. They're not going to give you any turnovers. And if Rink Rat is forced into turnovers, Black Ice will make them pay.
You mentioned that earlier. Normally, they're the underdog in this game. Black Ice has been the underdog in every single Pama Pro final so far. Now, They're the heavy favorite.
But is that more pressure? That's the thing. But and I don't think they have to, quote unquote, handle it. Yeah. It's just play your game, because now as a favorite, don't let the pressure get to you. Act like you've been playing the whole time. You've been a Pama Pro Invitational. Like you're the underdog in every championship game. Do it. Play that way. Act like you're playing from behind. They'll be just fine.
For those of you that don't know, and if you don't, you're crazy and you're living under a rock, let's meet the Mission Black Ice. Let's come back one more time and do a final little preview. There you have it, the heavily favored Mission Black Ice. I don't know what's going to happen, George, but what I do know is it's going to be fun because there are so many good and talented players on both of these teams.
Yeah, if you look up and down these rosters, and Black Ice has more of the guys that are strict roller daddies, and then you look on the other side and they've got more of the professional ice hockey players. So let's see what referees are reffing this game. This may be an underrated statistic.
Yes.
If we see the referees that are reffing this game and how they officiate this game, because I'm telling you now, Rink Rat's going to be physical, completely physical. And we had a questionable call the last time. We had a long conversation about if they're calling it like that, Rink Rat might not be able to get too physical. But it depends on how the game is called, because if they let a lot of body contact go, it might go in Rink Rat's favor.
George, I want you to pick one key player, and I think I already know him, for each team, who has to be unbelievable for their team to win.
TNT, Tommy Tartaglioni for Rink Rat. He's got to be amazing today. And on the other end, I'm going to surprise everybody. It's Sam Eisenhower. Sam Eisenhower has to perform today. He's one of those unsung hero types.
Yeah.
They know, Rink Rat knows to key on Tiefenwerth, to key on Pascali, to key on Kraft. Chavo knows about all those guys. But if Sam Eisenhower can come and pump one goal in, and just give him that extra pump, he's the key to Black Ice's success. That's a surprise one there for you.
And in the pregame visual we had, it's talked about where all these guys are from. Not only are all the Black Ice guys from pretty much the same place, a few Pennsylvania,
right, state area,
but they've been playing together for so long. And a theme that we've heard from a lot of people during this tournament is chemistry.
Yeah, and it's not just Mission Black Ice. It's Rink Rat has now played together for a couple years in this tournament. Even if they only get together for one tournament, you still know where your teammates are. You know what they're going to do in certain situations. All the top teams play together all the time.
Yeah.
And the bottom teams, you see, don't play together all the time. They pick up here and there. That's the importance of playing together. Even if it's for one tournament, you know what your line mate might do. You know what I mean? And it's those small detail things that can mean the championship in a tournament like this.
Another thing we've talked about a lot this tournament is scoring the first goal.
Oh, man.
How big is that going to be here?
To me, if it's scored on Black Ice, there's still no panic in them. But let me say this. If Black Ice gets that first goal, just watch to see how Rink Rat responds. Will the heads hang low?
Yeah.
Or do they come even harder? Your response after getting scored on first is what's biggest. Not the fact you got scored on, but your response to it. First day we talked, I wish I would have done it for the second day.
Yeah.
10-2 for the first goal scorers.
Yes.
10-2 record.
That's a impressive stat.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. It says a lot. It's ridiculous. 10-2 record. Excitement was one of the ones that forced a loss after getting the first goal, but that's the only thing we can hang our...
Not a big deal.
Yeah, that's
not
the only thing we can hang our hat on for the tournament so far. But honestly, it's going to be how they respond. We know that Black Ice is going to respond if they get scored on first. But how will Rink Rat respond if Black Ice gets the first goal?
I mean, I'm so pumped, George. I'm so pumped.
I can tell,
Travis. You know me.
I can tell.
I love the game. I love the sport of roller hockey. And I just got a feeling this one's going to be great, as they've been in the past, but this one's going to be fun.
So will we have a new Pama Pro Champion? This is the fourth year of it.
Yes.
Is it the first time that we get a new one? That's the question. That's what I'm interested in.
Or will the powerful Black Ice win another
and get their title right back?
George, here it is. You're getting put on the spot. Who you got?
As much as I love Cinderella stories, and Cinderella wanted to date me a long time ago, but as
you
long
lost a slipper though, right?
Couldn't find it.
Tough break, George.
But as long as I've loved Cinderella stories in all of sports, I would love to say that was happening today. But my brain is saying it's going to be Black Ice again. I would love to say it's going to be a low-scoring game, but I don't believe that either. I've got a 5-3 game, Black Ice.
There you have it. Black Ice wins 5-3, according to George Brown. Up next for $25,000, it's Mission Black Ice, it's Team Rink Rat, and it's up next on SWH Live. Welcome back in to SWH Live. Chris Trapp alongside George Brown and PJ Cavaya as we are set and ready to go for the Pama Pro Invitational Championship for all the marbles. $25,000 on the line. PJ, it's a packed house. This is the only thing going on right now at State Wars. The whole roller hockey world is watching. It's Rink Rat and it's Mission Black Ice.
This is what it's all about. This is going to be an awesome game, hopefully, here. And, yeah, absolutely packed barn right now.
Pro roller hockey supremacy on the line. I talked to George Brown in the pregame. PJ Cavaya, a player in this division. You've won it twice. What's it going to take to win this game?
You guys touched on it earlier in the pregame, but for Black Ice, keep their game plan the way it is. Don't change anything up. They know that they can win. They know that they in their minds, they think they have the better team, which they probably do on paper. They play great together. Rink Rat, they need to stay disciplined, stay out of the box, and they need to capitalize early if they have a chance.
I said in the pregame, I don't know what's going to happen in terms of results. All I do know is this is going to be fun, and I can't wait.
Let's get her going.
Here we go.
Here
we go, PJ.
Let's get her going.
Mission Black Ice, the number two seed. And recent Pama Pro Invitational champion will be in the purple jerseys with white and yellow trim going from right to left on your screen in period number one. Team Rink Rat looking for their first Pama Pro Invitational Championship in the bright yellow jerseys going from left to right. The puck is down and we are underway. $25,000 on the line. Tiefenworth has it for the Black Ice. He'll throw it back into his own zone. Kozlo takes it for Black Ice. Rink Rat's going to need a flawless game to defeat Black Ice. They're defending now as PJ DiMartino comes across the red line, backs up into his own zone to the near side. Parallel to the red stripe for Kozlo. 30 seconds in, PJ, and possession. All Black Ice right now. Slowing down the game, waiting for Rink Rat to make a mistake. They're going to need to be flawless defensively.
Faceoffs are going to be really important in this game, too, to maintain possession of the puck.
And staying out of the box. We talked about in the pregame, Black Ice power play. There's a good chance they're going to score if you give them the chance, so don't do it.
90 to 95%.
Billy Pascal moving slowly up the rink. He'll curl back. Not even advancing to their own zone yet. Off to Nate Gerger. Nate Gerger up the right side. Pass goes in front of Pascali. Cadiz has it. He was a force to be reckoned with in the semifinal win. Finds Eitan Chavera. He had the first goal of the last game. Out of the high slot. Mayhew back into his own zone. It's Joaquin Chavera.
I feel like for this first, you know, 5, maybe 7 minutes, it's going to be a feel-out process for both teams. See how guys are playing. And, yeah, they're going to try and obviously capitalize on their mistake.
Pass to the right side for Cadiz. Back to the far wing. Mayhew shoots. That one hits Kozlo. The skate goes wide. Out of the puck behind the net. It's won by the Black Ice. Here comes Kozlo. One of the steadfast defenders for Black Ice. Across the red line, left wing side. Goes to the back door. That one hits a skate and goes wide. Will Tommy Tartaglione's fatigue be a factor here? Because he was gassed at the end of that last game because it took a lot out of him. He faced so many shots against Pama.
Yeah, he could be very tired right now, which he seemed at the end of the game, the semis. But I think for Tommy, he's a veteran player. He'll know what to do to figure it out.
Joaquin Chavera with the first shot of the game, and it's blockered aside by the Philly native, Machinsky. Now Shava, 2 goals in the semifinal win. A wrist shot, Tartan. Leone makes the save. Joaquin Chavera gets the rebound. Behind the net for Corey Hodge, Detroit native, around the near side. Joaquin has some trouble with it, but it gets it back behind the goal. Now up the near boards. Nice move by Matt Berry. Berry down the left wing. 1-on-2 coming to the zone. Tries to cut to the middle. It gets around the defenseman with the puck, but not his body. And it goes into the corner. He'll get to it first and fire it back into his own zone. Rink wide feet to the far side. That one right on the money. Morgarella. He goes back in behind the goal for Hodge. Rink Rat with their first steady possession so far. Pass to the left wing side. It misses Garrett Ross. Goes in behind the goal. Matt Gerber plays it to his brother Nate on the far side. He'll skate up the flank. To the red line for Billy Pascali. Pascali to the high slot. Cuts to the middle. Puck skitters away from him and goes down into the left corner. How this game is called will be a factor, PJ.
Yeah, 100%. Obviously, Black Eyes power play, very deadly. And I would agree the same thing about Ringrath's power play. They have four forwards out there. So, yeah, they're no stranger to scoring goals on power plays.
Groff, far side, top of the circle. Backhand shot. Tartag Leone soaks it up like a sponge. And not just because he looks like one with the yellow jerseys. He gets the whistle with 14:34 left in the first. Your referees today, Stephen Renault and Mike Sarter. If you had to pick two referees to do this game, these are the ones with the most experience, and these are the top two officials. So.
Yeah, this is not their first pro roller final, so yeah, these guys, they know what they're doing.
Renault does American Hockey League games all season, and he always does IIHF games for ICE as well. So a veteran official.
They're going to let the boys play.
Pascali into his offensive zone, left wing side. He picks up speed, tries to play to the back door, gets it there. And it hits off his skate, comes to DiMartino, backhand shot on goal. Tartaglione says no.
Coming up huge already. TNT, baby.
A dynamite save. I stole your pun. That
dynamite
was,
save.
That was yours from last game.
I but think he'll have a few of those.
An excellent stop. Tyler Kraft. Face off. In the near side circle, Tartaglione. Wiping that sweat off his head. He was sweating so much. After last game, we had to take the tiles out of the crease and put new ones in.
I actually did see that. I didn't know what it was from, but that makes sense.
I don't know if that's a good thing or if it's just sad.
Tommy's a sweater. I told you that last game. He really is. It's crazy. A lot of goalies are, I feel like. So is Redmond, but like Tommy's the worst.
I don't sweat that much because of the fact that I just don't have to work too hard to make my saves. I don't make many of them.
But you don't make saves. You don't play anymore.
I just ripped myself before you could even rip me, Trafty. Nice try.
13:50 left in the first period. Here comes Cadiz, looking for the game's first goal. He's in the high slot. He cuts to his left. Cadiz, backhand shot. Machinski the save. Rebound. He scores! Team Rinkrat gets the game's first goal for Tegan.
Well, we know what bench I'm going to go on first.
So I wonder what Black Ice is complaining about here, because I didn't actually see the puck go in the net. It didn't hit the net, I don't think.
Same here. I think they're saying that Machinski was in the net when he made the save.
You're probably
because
right
from
about
the
that.
Waist back, he was in the net.
He was in the net.
He made the save with his chest. So referee Mike Sarter, that's a gutsy call because.
And he was in. He was actually in perfect position for it. He was, and he made that call. He saw. He knew what he saw, and he called it.
Jay Muro not arguing too much. So Rinkrat gets the game's first goal. George, we talked about how huge that first goal is.
And listen, you know Black Ice isn't going to panic about it at all. But for Rinkrat to get it, that was even bigger than if... For Rinkrat to get it, that was even bigger than if Black Ice was trailing, if that makes any sense. Black Ice doesn't worry about trailing. Rinkrat would have been an uphill battle if they didn't get the first goal.
It'll make the game way more interesting for sure.
Tegan gets the glory, but the whole play was made by Cadiz, who went coast to coast.
Flying.
Got two Black Ice skaters to commit to him, threw it to the front of the net. The first stop was made by Machinski, a beautiful one, and then he put in the rebound. Chavera looking for a 2-0 lead. Backhand shot, he scores!
Like, just look at how explosive
wow.
Junior Cadiz is. Listen, he's taken over the entire game here.
Once
Junior Cadiz has taken over this entire thing. It's ridiculous.
Cadiz threads the needle.
Of course you did. You have a Rinkrat jersey on. You love it.
Cadiz threads the needle. Eitan Trivera finishes off the play with a beautiful backhand. It's 2-0 Rinkrat. 5 minutes into the first period.
Has Black Ice trailed by 2 all tournament?
Oh. Have they trailed at all during the tournament? No.
No.
They haven't. Pascali into his offensive zone. Cuts to the middle. It's poked away by Eitan Trivera. Joaquin will get to it. Trivera into the zone. Joaquin, high slot. Wrister glove save made by Machinski.
And listen, Kozlov lost his containment on Eitan Trivera. Trivera got around him. It was Kozlov on the defense there, so Eitan got around him to put that backhand home.
And what a heads-up play by Junior. Obviously, he's a forward. Everybody
oh,
knows
man.
How great he is,
he
but what a
does
pass.
Everything. PJ, you're exactly right. He just does everything and makes it look so easy.
He was behind the net in right. where a forward doesn't normally
right.
hang out, and
right.
he made an unreal pass.
The whole length of the rink up to the opposite blue line.
And obviously, Eitan knows exactly what to do in that situation.
Man, oh man.
Rinkrat has came to play. 12:20 left in the first, puck the far side. Here's a
this
turnover.
This is what can happen.
A 2-on-1. Kraft, look at the back check by
Garrett
Ross.
Ross.
Kraft couldn't even get a
Garrett
shot.
Ross, a great
play.
The leading scorer in the division, stymied via the back check of Garrett Ross.
Oh, guys, can we talk about how this place is packed out?
Perella over to the far side for Matt Barry in front of a nearly sold-out St. Peter's Recplex.
I don't know if I've seen more people at a pro final in roller hockey than this.
It's been years if I have.
This is the perfect ring for it, too.
But let me not just say that. Let me say this. The scheduling, not to have any other games happening at this time.
Brilliant.
Genius.
Genius, exactly. Stole the words out of my mouth, Georgie.
I know, man. We think alike, bro.
There's maybe one section that has a little bit of seating, and it's on the camera side. But on this side, people are searching for a seat. They can't find it.
Well, that's because we have our big thing up there, not letting anybody through.
I put up there for a reason. Right. I don't want people coming and talking to me. Oh, to the broadcast. Which you think wouldn't happen as much as it does.
Everybody's trying to find a spot for this game, though.
Garrett Ross, far side. He's used
smart
to playing.
Play. He wanted to drop it back to Matt Barry, but he didn't.
He's used
because
to
Barry was going for the chain.
A bunch of people playing in the American Hockey League.
Listen, there's going to be...
Now, let's talk about this. There's a lot of pro ice guys on Rink Rat. Is Black Ice intimidated here with all the people? Chavo goes in, gets poked away.
I don't think so at all. And right now, I think Rink Rat's got to stay disciplined. That's going to be the key for them right now.
But have we ever seen a chance where Black Ice is one and done? They're not keeping possession. It's one and done for them right now.
If at all.
Like, this is crazy.
A perfect start for Rink Rat. The only problem is... 18-minute periods. We still got 28 minutes to go.
Okay, so here's my thing. The coaching styles are a lot different because it seems like Jason and Aaron coach back there. There's not much. I mean, they're more so coaching themselves here on the Rink Rat bench, which is fine. They've got some leadership behind here with Dan Maxwell. But
Cadiz, high slot, cut to the backhand. Oh. Pad stop made by Machinsky. He's come up huge since giving up that second goal. Yep. Most goalies might have gone into a shell, lost their confidence. He hasn't. He's made some big saves since it became 2-0. Now DiMartino looks to make it 2-1 into the zone, to the backhand. Tries a forehand shot. Tartaglione denies it and gets the cover.
And they've got some leadership down here, but I'm telling you right now, they're going to roll. Right now, they're going to roll a matter of about 8 to 10 guys on the Rink Rat bench.
Georgie, is that a concern?
I don't think so.
Being 18-minute periods, long periods?
I would love to say it is, but Junior Cadiz is one of those guys that's going every other shift. When do you ever see him get tired?
That's a good point. He doesn't look like he's tired. I'm sure he's tired on the inside, but he's not going to show
sure.
it.
But then also, how much do you have to push now? You're up 2-0. You can take your rest behind the net and controlling the puck.
Exactly.
But I think they should keep playing the way they're playing. If they sit back in the shell, bad things might happen.
Not saying they would, but why not?
Matt Gerger to the front of the net. Tartaglione makes the
save.
Oh,
that is one of the most annoying things ever that Tommy Tartaglione does.
Hey, you know, we talked about him the other game, right? He's just a veteran guy. And in situations like that, like, that's obviously beneficial for Rink Rat. I know
Absolutely.
He's not doing it on purpose.
No, he is.
Maybe he is, maybe he's not. You can't say yes or no.
But as long as Tommy Tartaglione has done that, Tommy Tartaglione is not stupid. He's a smart goaltender. When there's something coming down on that end, if he has a chance to knock the net off, he's doing it.
And he's doing it where he's not taking a penalty either.
Right. It's impossible to call it. You can't call a penalty on that.
Exactly.
His Indian name is not Netsov. That could be a Russian name.
TNT, baby.
Cadiz hanging out behind the goal. Right now, you can give him the nickname of MVP because that's what he's been so far. Pass to the right side for Eitan Chabert. He comes into the zone. Eisenhower watching.
So I'm talking to Nick Wydock, backup goaltender on the bench, and of course he's taken up for TNT like big time. He's like, there's nothing you can do about that. Yeah, okay.
He's right, though.
Yeah, he is right, but PJ, how long have we watched TNT play?
Has it ever not been
the case?
Well, he does things so weird,
No, he knows when his team's tired, and if they're tired or there's an opportunity the other way against him, he's going to do something that's going to benefit
his
team.
But that's what I'm saying, PJ, so I don't want to hear the fact that it's on purpose or not on purpose. He knows what he's doing.
Accidentally on purpose,
right.
We'll leave it at that.
He knows what he's doing.
Yeah, but, I'm not saying it's annoying to everybody in the building or on the other team, but I guarantee you it works for his team.
It's a veteran play.
Absolutely. Smart play.
Throwing the puck right now. Rink Rat down to Junior Cadiz.
Notice what Rink Rat is doing to break the man-to-man system for Black Ice. Notice what they do every single time. PJ, watch this. They'll take it and do Rink the length of the rink passes to break the man-to-man system. So Black Ice has to turn their back and skate back on the back check.
Uh-oh, turn over here. Paliskali up front! And the shot was blocked. And it's held on by Tartaglione.
But if they're not there in time, what happened with Ethan will happen. Because now all Black Ice players to give help. Like when you're coming down and you get beat, but your defensemen are there, you got help. But if you make a length of the rink pass and you've got one-on-one, how quick can your other three guys get there? They can't really get there in time, and that's how Ethan Chavera got his goal. He was one-on-one.
Exactly, and Junior made the right call on that bank pass.
Absolutely, and they're going to continue to do it. You see stretch passes happening all the time here. And I think no matter who you're playing with the talent on this bench, they'll go one-on-one all day.
And they're totally fine sitting behind the net for as long as they need now.
And that's what I was saying, Treffy, also. They're not going to change their game, but until they're chased and have to move it, this is where you get your rest right here, too.
Exactly.
You keep moving on them, but listen, if you're going to roll 8 to 10 guys, you're going to keep getting your rest. I'm telling you right now, they're running. It looks like Cal O'Reilly at the end of the bench has his gloves off. I don't even think he...
Well, actually talked to Maxwell about this, and he said he wasn't confident going out there and playing. He's just not confident in his skating abilities because he's a nice guy. It's his first time really playing
listen,
roller. Like, if they get a power play, he's going to be out there.
Play him all around Robin, but I'm telling you right now, Cal O'Reilly, that's so unselfish, man, to know...
Yeah.
That you could possibly hurt your team because of your skating ability at this point?
Well, I mean, he's always been a leader. Look at him in ice hockey. Everywhere he's gone, he's been a captain, assistant captain in the American Hockey League level. When he goes up the NHL, he plays a third and fourth line role, and he does it to perfection. He is a great team guy.
Georgie, yeah, you nailed it on the head. That's super unselfish. How many guys would actually do that and admit it and know that they're not good enough to skate at this level?
Especially a guy who has the highest pedigree of ice hockey in this entire building.
That's such a selfless
move. Except for
move.
Maybe if his brother was here, like he was last night. DiMartino to the front of the net, jumped on goal, but goes wide of the net.
But now, stick broken, but not only that, but for Cal O'Reilly to not only do that.
Turnover, DiMartino in front, Shabo turns, fires, save Tartaglione.
Wow.
Wow. Wow, I definitely thought that was going in.
Me too. For Cal O'Reilly to be on the bench, supporting his team, and be out here dressed, that's huge. There are going to be three players. There are, let me count this, and I'm going to tell you right now, and this is why I said it. Right now there are eight players on the bench. Three of them are not playing at all. Two of them are youngsters, and one of them is Cal O'Reilly. Eight players, so that means there's five on the bench, four on the rink. Like we said, they're rotating nine guys this entire game, I can promise you that. And I'll tell you why they won't get those guys in the game. Hayden Maxwell and the other youngster, I got to get the name. They're not going to be in the game unless the score is 4-5-0. I guarantee you it's probably not going to get to that point today.
Chase Edwards will be your other youngster. George Brown. The only reason I knew that is because I had to...
Chase Edwards, you said?
Yeah. I would assume he's the other young ones, considering I had to rip out those meet the players things in about...
Right, all right.
10 minutes. Puck behind the net, Mayhew. Moves up the middle of the rink. Meandering around in his own zone. I feel like Black Ice hasn't touched the puck in forever. It's been a few small little miscues from Rink Rat, but every time they mess up, they've done a phenomenal job of recovering and not allowing a chance.
You know, the one thing about Rink Rat is their team. They don't have a bunch of defensemen, but their guys on forward who are playing D, they're communicating in the best way possible. They know where to be. They know what they're doing, and it's awesome to see.
And here comes Cadiz, right wing side. Around the back of the net, the puck just skittered away from him. Now possession of Black Ice. We'll see what they can do with it.
Keedy's upset there as he lost control of the puck.
Black Ice with full possession and a breakout for the first time in a while. Now to Pascali. He'll be watched by Keedy's entering the zone. Billy Pascali, a shot. Tartaglione just kicks it to the corner. Pass around the boards. Keedy's got a piece of it, but not enough as it goes the full length. 4:48 left in the first period. Matt Gerger has it for Black Ice with his team trailing 2-0. PJ.
When was the last time you said that?
I don't remember.
Yeah, me neither.
Maybe last year in the championship to the Snipers?
Maybe. Yeah.
Up to the far side. DiMartino. Up the right wing. Pascali has it. Billy Pascali. Cuts to the front, tries to toe drag the outside, blocked and sent back down. Team defense right now by Rinkrad.
Listen,
they're playing great team
defense. And this is not because you're on air, PJ, but one person we say a lot.
Matt Gerger, wrist shot, Tartaglione fights it off to the near side.
One person we say a lot of the top defenseman in the game is you. And up to the challenge always, as well as Joaquin Chavera. He's one of the strongest defensemen out there.
Yeah, for sure. He's a gamer, and he's been through these games before. He knows what to do, and he's a veteran guy.
Talked about the leadership of Tyler Kraft. He's going to look to lead his team back up, at least to a tie. Over to DiMartino. Wrist shot. That one's blocked. Goes up and out of play. Regrat's going to have to block shots, too, even though they got a steadfast goaltender in Tartag Leone. Border Cats beat you guys because they blocked a lot of shots.
A ton of shots.
And it forced them, or forced you guys to try to do something different. Try to move. Try to do different plays. You were forcing things because you couldn't get stuff through. That's what Regrat needs to do, and that's what they've done so far. They need to continue.
They got to buy in and sacrifice.
Puck is down. It's a face-off win back to the left point. You talked about big face-offs word. Black Ice wins that one in their offensive zone. DiMartino over to the far wall. Tries to fire it to the back door. Gets off a stick and goes into the corner. Not just blocking shots, but blocking passes like that is important. Garrett Ross comes away with the puck.
Garrett Ross finding the puck everywhere.
He's been a magnet on his stick so far this game. He scored the first goal and a huge one in the semifinal.
And Garrett Ross, he's got his head on a swivel, and if it's not 100% change, he's not making the play. He had a guy streaking behind him toward the net. He could have made that pass, but Black Ice could have stepped up and stole it because he looked there, but he said, you know what, why take that chance? Another stretch pass again.
Garrett Ross has it. Watched by Kozlo. Tries to spin a ram, but the puck just got away from him. Nice defense. Kozlo gets a little piece of it.
They're doing it every single time, that stretch play, and they can't get their guys there enough time to help.
Morella. Oh. Went to the high slot. Cadiz missed it. John Chavo one-on-one with Hodge. Chavo. Toldrick shot. Tartag Leone to save.
Tommy coming up big there.
Rink, oh, my.
Stretch pass. Garrett Ross is on a breakaway. Shoots. Save Machinsky. He stops the rebound, too.
Save.
It's a dangerous, dangerous goal score. Now Nate Gerger.
Questionable change by Black Ice.
He's a defenseman, Nate Gerger, but he scored some big goals in championships. Tours here. He's done it. It's DeJohn Chavo speaking of scoring big goals. Puck on the far side. Out high. Nate Gerger to the near wing. Chavo has room. Shoots!
Oh, wow. How is he getting these shots?
Tartag Leone got a piece and it trickled wide oh so slowly. Tyler Kraft, right wing side, over to the near boards. John Chavo in the center circle, watched by Garrett Ross. Chavo fakes the go back, comes down the right side. Now Chavo wraps it around the boards to keep possession for Black Ice.
First time Black Ice has had possession longer than a minute and a half. Longer than 45 seconds, actually.
16 minutes and 20 seconds into the first period. Pascali, high slot, goes to his backhand, it slides off him.
Oh, Cadiz wanted to pick off that pass.
The centering feed blocked by Hodge. Now Hodge throws up the near side. That was such a patient play by Corey Hodge. Now he has it behind the net. Round of applause for the Rink Rat crew because of that good defense by Hodge. We talked about him with Jay Miro even, about how he's a good player, and he's versatile. Every team could use a guy like Corey Hodge, and he's had a really good game quietly so far because he's shut down some big players.
Yeah, I agree with that. Even the shot when Chavo, I know how to pronounce his name. Even the shot with John Chavo, he had to shoot it against, going with the grain, so couldn't even shoot it back the opposite way because of the fact that Hodge took everything else away. And if he shoots it up, if he shoots it off the ground, Hodge is blocking it. So he went between his legs in the only spot he could. Hodge took everything away.
Pascali, high slot to the far side. Hey, Gerger back in front. That one goes over to the near boards. Pascali now, wrist shot. That one goes wide to the right post. Junior Cadiz gets to a puck. Oh, and then a high stick by Pascali clips Cadiz. And a Rink Rat power play.
Gonna check him right now.
With them leading by two. This is huge in this game. If Rink Rat scores, they're up by a field goal.
He's scratched up like he got smacked with a stick.
If the Black Ice can kill this off, then they have a lot of momentum. And it'll carry over to next period if Rink Rat can't score here.
Deadly power play, though.
This is a big, big time in the game. Man, you know that show NFL Turning Point? This would be on the show if there's a goal in any which way.
TSN Turning Point,
might
too.
Might not be enough content for a full show. Puck chipped up on the near side boards. Here comes Tyler Kraft. He's got 10 seconds. He's going to go for it. Kraft against Cadiz, try to cut to the middle.
But now here, oh my. Oh my.
I don't know about that.
What an awful call.
Yeah. That was pretty good D, and Crafty just lost the
handle,
I thought.
That is the worst call of the game so far.
But, hey, give Kraft kudos for selling it. Like, he got hooked up a little bit. Not enough name for a call, but he made the referee know that he thought he got hooked, and he did a good job of convincing because he called it.
Well, it's just even up then.
Now Eitan Chabera has it. He's got 2 seconds left, takes a long shot, and the horn sounds. But you know what? If you're going to take a penalty against the Black Ice, do it really early into your power play so you don't have to face their power play for too long. But 3-on-3 as we start period number 2 with Rink Rat leading 2-0. We will step out for a break, and when we return, the second and potentially final period, we could be giving away $25,000, a 2-0 advantage for Rink Rat over Mission Black Ice. This is SWH Live. Back into SWH.
I'm going with Joaquin.
We're going to head down to downtown George Brown as we get set for period number 2 here on SWH Live.
Here with Coach Dan Maxwell. Dan, what do you tell the guys that are in a mission?
Well, these guys are good, and they got good feet, so we just have to stay inside of them. We can't let them get odd man rushes. They get odd man rushes, they score. That's how we got beat last time. 3 big mistakes and it catastrophic. They scored every one. So we are just working our ass off trying to stay inside of them.
Coach Dan Maxwell, thank you. I'll let you get back to the game. Good luck.
All right, that was Coach Dan Maxwell here on the Rink Rat bench. Rink Rat up 2-0 on Black Ice. Coming back to you, back upstairs with second period action.
Chris Trapped alongside George Brown and PJ Cavaya. We're set ready to go for period number 2. Rink Rat from right to left, Black Ice from left to right. We're skating 3-on-3 for 1:08, and then a short abbreviated power play for the Black Ice.
I'm a little worried about that short abbreviated power play because they can strike at any time.
It only takes 5 seconds.
Hey,
that's
why if you're smart here and your rink rat, you keep possession near the end of this 3-on-3. You keep possession and then kill the last 18.
Joaquin Chabera loses stick, but DiMartino can't take advantage of it.
Yeah, and that's why that faceoff is huge, Georgie, because, you talk about possession right now. Black Ice is probably going to control it until they get that power play.
But the next time Rink Rat gets possession, if they do, keep it until they kill the penalty. But there's only an 18-second differential.
But they can still score.
Matt Gerger tries a wrist shot. That one's blocked. There's a battle in front. They're trying to find the loose puck. DiMartino does.
Now you kill it.
Sends it back into his own zone. Kraft is going to kill the rest of his team's
and they're going to
penalty.
Change the power play unit. Kraft jumps.
Looks like they're going to have
and he wants
out.
Billy to come over here for KJ. Will KJ go out or no? Will Billy go out?
18 seconds.
So KJ is going out, and that's the power play coming for 15. And he's going to get to his position. It's basically a 10-second power play here.
Kraft on to Chavo. Back to Kraft to the near side. DiMartino. Kraft again. Down low. Chavo waiting, looking, shooting. Tartaglione makes
it away, and that's even now. They took that away. They took the Chavo shot away.
Over to the far side. Kraft not out of the water yet. Is Rink Rat. They try to go to the near side.
Now they can man up.
Nice deep from Garrett Ross to get a piece of it. Tiefenworth. High slot wrist shot. That one goes over top of the net. Lands on the back of the goal. And Hodge, very assertive, to just try to get that whistle because he knew it was going to go outside.
Yeah, I don't think TNT saw that shot either.
No, not at all. Just think if that penalty wasn't called, if it was 3-0 right now, how much Black Ice would have to push, you know? But it's still 2-0. They can still play their game, right, PJ?
If there's any team that can come back from any deficit, it's definitely this team.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
For me, if I'm Rink Rat, though, you're really focusing. If there's one guy you got to focus on, I know they have a team full of great players, but Chavo's the guy.
Yeah, because we talked about big game goal scoring, you know?
He's the guy, for me, at least. He's the guy that's going to change the game.
But you know what? Rink Rat can't change their game up because every single player has been responsible as ever defensively.
today, you know?
And they have to keep that up if they want to win.
Nate Berger into his offensive zone, trying to cut this lead in half.
Yo, Corey Hodge is so smart. Ethan Chavera was skating next to Nate Berger, but just in case Berger got by him, Corey Hodge left his man just a little bit, just in case he needed help. And in that situation, he would have helped. And I guarantee you, Ethan would have probably fell off to Corey Hodge's old man. And that's how you play the man-to-man system, and they're doing it perfectly right now.
Pascali gets free, but the pass was way too hard.
Corey's that underrated defenseman that nobody talks about, but should be talked about because
he's so
versatile, like you said.
Corey Hodge.
It was just a stick lift there. Nobody talks about it.
Pascali, wrist shot.
And there you go, another block.
Corey Hodge. Listen, nobody talks about the guy. Nobody talks about the guy, but I'm telling you right now, easily, top five defenseman in this game.
He's also played, you know, on a couple teams that have not been very successful in big tournaments like this, and now that he's on this team, he is the defensive guy on their squad.
Listen, he's always been the leader on that infamous team, the guy that put teams together, the infamous team that would play tours and NARS. Always been the leader on there, and so he didn't get his name recognition. They won D1 for a year or something, and maybe made semis and pro, but never had that major success, and so nobody knew about him. But when you get guys like this to ask you to play, you know you have a name for yourself.
And like we said, Jay Muro was giving him high compliments.
Right, absolutely.
And he has, quote unquote, the best team in pro roller hockey, and he had a lot of nice things to say about Mr. Hot. Kraft sends one towards the goal, deflected by
Kraft. PJ, are you going to say something too?
No, we're good.
All right. No, I was just, it's the fact of the matter that Corey Hodge, every time he steps on the rink, he just doesn't hurt you.
Wrist shot.
I was actually going to say, now that you brought it up, yeah, I was going to mention, this could be a shot in the dark here, but for me, as a overall tournament team standpoint, he's my MVP, because without him, without a guy that's back there doing
have one defensive.
That's what
like
I mean. Without a guy doing the D work that they need, because they can score. We know they can score, but yeah, you need a guy that'll be the D man. Kaji doesn't care if he scores or not. If he does, it's a bonus.
It's just smart for them to even ask him, PJ.
Right, exactly.
Because they know it's a team makeup.
And a guy like Joaquin, who will be just a defenseman too, then you have their top four forwards who are getting it done right now.
And listen, you're going to – and their top four forwards aren't getting tired either. Joaquin, it's a situation where –
the game's so slow, they're not going to get tired right now.
Just think if he was the only team. Just think if he was the only defenseman on the team, Joaquin.
DiMartino.
It'd be tougher for them.
Spin a rim, a pass, Kraft, one-timer goes wide. Watch out for
But
Kraft.
Now you got every single time you're throwing Joaquin or Corey.
How is Kraft keeping this puck alive?
Joaquin or Corey Hodges on the rink.
Yeah, they have to change for each other.
And
if you're rink
right. And then later in the game, watch. Both of them will be on the rink if they're the...
Yeah, now Hodges jumps out for a forward. For the other D, sorry.
Over to Matt Barry. Former San Diego goal.
Not what you want. That's not what you want if you're Matt Barry.
Over to the neutral zone. Here's Pascali against Corey Hodges. He beats him. Tartaglioni the poke check. His helmet comes off.
Yo, Tommy Tartaglia. PJ, was it you that said he's another defenseman out there?
He actually is. I'm telling you, this is true.
I mean, because once you make the move around the defenseman, by the time you lift your head up, Tartaglioni's there.
Tommy knew exactly what Billy was going to do. Yeah, we just talked about how great Corey is. And right there, he got walked around. He didn't get go through, but Billy went around him. And Tommy read the play just like any other D-man would. But he's a goalie. It's different. He comes out with a sliding poke check that he always does. And
absolutely.
Works once again.
I mean, if he stays there like a normal goalie, he's going to get beat.
He's going to get beat.
Exactly.
He can't move.
And it's the hardest thing to move across. And Corey Hodge is not the quickest dude, but positionally, he's so sound. So going around the outside might have hurt him there, but Tommy T said, yo, you want to go out on the outside? I got your name. I got your number. And he just helped out as the next defenseman.
Nate Berger in front of the benches, slowly. A breakdown here for Rinkrat in the last few minutes. Pascali, and a penalty coming here.
Whoa. I don't like that call either.
It was kind of interference, but yeah, it was a little soft.
Here's the thing. Garrett Ross jumped in to Nate Gerger. He jumped into him.
Selling the play like the first penalty that Rinkrat got?
There you go. He jumped into it.
Boys, there's 25 on the line here. Hey, they're going to do anything it takes to get a power play, an advantage, anything. And when we're talking about TNT, we're talking about as a defenseman. This is a little unknown fact, but he actually has a goal in ice hockey.
Who?
Tommy TNT. He's actually scored a goal.
Stop it.
I'm not even lying.
You allow black guys to get the puck on the penalty kill, and they're dangerous there, too.
Pascali in, shoots, he missed it way wide. Pascali trying to draw a call.
I don't see. Here's the thing. I don't see why they're. Never mind. Hold on.
Cadiz, high slot to the near side. Matt Beery to the back door. Deflects just wide.
That was deflected off the post by Gerger.
Matt Gerger skating down the right wing side. A wrist shot. That one goes up into the mesh.
So here's the thing. Billy Pascali's out killing. That is the first time I have ever, well, all tournament, seen somebody just take it down the rink and take the one shot. Black guys, and PJ, correct me if I'm wrong, but black guys usually done, and I know they're only down two nothing, but they usually don't go straight for that shot. They try to kill the whole penalty with puck possession, correct?
Yeah, but right now they're usually up, so right now they're down. They need a goal right now, and I'm not saying that they
have 11 minutes left after this.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, but they're thinking that they need to maybe get one now to kind of make things a little bit easier for them at the end of the game.
What a move by DiMartino! Wrist shot is stopped by Tartaglioni.
And look at PJ DiMartino. He's up D man. He's pressing on the kill.
Yo, DiMartino's so ridiculously good. But no, I mean that, and like I said, on the penalty. Ross jumped into Gerger and went down. So I make up call, huh?
Eitan Chavero, wrist shot. That
Billy Pascali, great block.
Pucks it up ahead, pops up into the air.
Uh-oh.
Matt Gerger pokes it up. A penalty coming
he
here.
Got
in
it. He got it.
The referees have set a precedent here in this game, and they're calling it consistently. I think.
This will be the first full power play if they hold the 10 seconds. This will be the first full power play the Black Ice has gotten for the game.
And we know how dangerous they are. On 5-on-4-2. Taking their time. Now Matt Gerger's into the zone. He can't come back across the red line. Kraft inches his way on the far point. He's going to get the puck. Matt Gerger for Tiefenwerth. Back to Matt Gerger. Tiefenwerth again. Quinnipiac product. Now for Coslow. Back to Tiefenwerth. Out high for Matt Gerger. Now to Tiefenwerth. Now low to Coslow. Coslow out to Tiefenwerth. Up for Matt Gerger. Far side, Kraft. Back to Matt Gerger. Tiefenwerth once more. Down low for Coslow. Coslow tries to go cross rink. It's partially deflected, but it comes to Kraft. Matt Gerger over for Tiefenwerth. Back to Matt Gerger. Big slap shot. That is blocked.
What a block by Rossi.
By Ross, and goes up into the mesh. And now here we go. Guys, we talked about it. Mission Black Ice power play. These are prognosticated numbers, but we usually say 90% of the time they're going to score. If they do score, it's going to be huge. Rink Rat needs a penalty kill here.
Obviously, if you're Black Ice, you need a goal right now.
Listen, here's the thing. We talked about it pregame. It's going to be KJ Tiefenwerth down low on the right side. It's going to be PJ DiMartino up high on the right side. Kraft will be up high on the left. And Chavo will be down low on the left, taking that shot away from Kraft and Chavo at the same time is going to be huge. But even if you do that, you've got to play the same thing on the right side.
Kraft down low to Chavo, fakes
the
shot.
That's what they want to take away.
Back up to Kraft. Now DiMartino. DiMartino down low. Tiefenwerth. DiMartino, Kraft. Kraft shoots. It's blocked. It goes up into the net.
And listen, here's the thing. Even with Joaquin Chavira down low, taking away the Chavo shot. Junior Cadiz was huge there, reaching in to take away the Kraft shot.
Junior's sneakily good on the penalty kill too up top. He reads plays really well too, and he's got a great stick.
Well, here's what it is. Kraft is on his one-time side though. DiMartino's not, so it's going to be easier.
DiMartino wrister glove save Tartaglioni. The rebound is sent down by Mayhew.
It's going to be easier for Cadiz to take that shot away. Because Cadiz is a righty. Easier to take that away.
Yeah, exactly. Sticks in his left hand.
On a butterfly goalie, that shot might have went in, but it hit Tartaglioni, who was still standing in the glove. Another wrist shot and a glove save. Once again, that was labeled top left, but Tartaglioni wasn't even going down yet.
Tommy knows. He's such a smart goalie, and he obviously knows exactly what Black Ice is trying to do. He's just eliminating all their options right now.
Yeah. Again, another defenseman. And that's the thing we're talking about right there. Junior Cadiz being a righty is going to take the shot away from Kraft. But then they're pasted. Joaquin is pasted to Chavo. And then they're giving the shot up away to DiMartino. And Tommy T knows that.
Exactly. By Black Ice. Cadiz gets caught out high. DiMartino to the far side. Kraft down low. Chavo puts it off the side of the goal.
That's a goal that Chavo always scores, though.
Cadiz gets to the puck. He dances around the forecheck. Now it's center. He gets around Kraft, but it just popped away. Nifty play by Kraft to poke that away last second after he got beat. Still 20 seconds in the power play. Kraft, far side, DiMartino, big slap shot. Tard Taglioni makes the save.
Yeah, you're right. They're letting PJ shoot, though.
Yeah, and I don't know if that's the plan, but it's almost impossible because PJ's righty as well, so there's not a one-timer there. If
he's going to see the shot.
Exactly.
With Junior being in the middle, if PJ was a lefty, it'd be easier to defend both of them. But he can't get all the way over there
Black
and then
ice.
Get back to Kraft.
Face-off win. Far side. Pascali. Down low to Schaubel. Back to Pascali. Wrist shot. Tartaglioni makes the save.
They took Kraft off.
But I think they did because
he was
tired.
But the penalty is ending here shortly, too.
Here's my question. It's not even a shooter. It's the fact that he's a righty. And yeah. So it's easier for Gadeen to take it away, especially when they're like, yo, they're letting PJ shoot on the other side.
Yeah, and it's almost like Rinkrat's game plan was just hey, it's going to be PJ versus Tommy, and Tommy just beat him if you can. Yeah.
4 seconds left. Matt Gerger down for Pascali. Tried to center, and it's blocked. Comes back to him, though. Out high for Matt Gerger. Wrist shot. He gets a stick lifted from behind.
What a kill.
Save his man.
We talked about 90%. Hey, that's a huge kill for Rinkrat.
And PJ, we talked about it. Having a righty defend as your top guy in that power play against the righty Kraft, then just getting the shot away to DiMartino on the right-hand side because he's a righty. That's the only thing you can do in that situation, or Kraft and Schaubel will kill you on the left-hand side.
And then once again, Tommy cleaning the crease because it's probably soaked and drawing a little bit more time for his team to rest. Seriously, veteran moves.
No, I get it.
Face off one by Black Ice. Puck comes out to the red line. Matt Gerger will hang out in his own zone. 9:02 left in the second period. If you are the Black Ice, that clock's moving fast. If you're a rink rat, looks like an eternity up there. Nate Gerger to the right wing side. Pascali tried to go to the back post. It's blocked.
That was iffy if you're rink rat because Hodge had to step up on the puck but let his guy go on the
wing. Rister. Nate Gerger was in front, but it went wide. He missed it. He tried to go back. Into the Black Ice zone, intercepted.
Here's going to be the biggest thing. Rinkrat cannot turn the puck over here because what's going to happen is now Black Ice is going to have a guy pasted to the back guy. If Rinkrat just starts throwing it back to kill time, there's going to be a guy man-to-man there. Like, Black Ice always helps and back checks and sometimes doesn't even worry about the high guy. This time they're going to have somebody pasted. So if they just throw it back, PJ, there's always going to be somebody there and it might cause a turnover.
Yeah,
and you did there.
You just have to be aware.
You can't just throw it back blindly now.
Exactly.
Corey Hodge.
If you're Black Ice, you need to start pressing a little bit, but you're not still up for grabs.
I was going to go with a joke that wasn't politically correct, because Crafty cut you off after you said, and if you're black, and I'm like, I am, but I just stayed away
so
from
you
it.
You still said the joke.
I did, but I stayed away from it, because I said I stayed away from it when I really didn't, but it wasn't a joke, it was real.
DiMartino to Matt Gerger, left side. Stops up right in front of the rink rat bench. Back to DiMartino. DiMartino tried to get in front. Schaubel sends it back
rink
to the
rat
point.
Is taking the middle of the rink away every single time it's pumped there.
Kraft is standing right in Tartaglioni's grill. Now he moves to receive a pass from DiMartino far side. He'll leave it for Schaubel. Black Ice is moving the puck. Back to the point. Groff, his first shift in a while.
They're literally just playing like a man-on-man box, but in their zone, protecting the middle.
But listen, and every time...
Schaubel long shot. Tartaglioni makes the save.
And every time it goes up top, it's a forward stepping through.
Puck sent down by Rinkrat. Bouncing down to the Black Ice zone. Machinsky settles it and gives it to DiMartino. 6:52 left in the second. Up for Schaubel. Schaubel to DiMartino. Long-range shot blocked in front. George, they're just keeping it simple now. They're just trying to get traffic to get shots.
Yeah, but they're not even, Rinkrat's not even allowing the flexing. There's a stick in front of the Black Ice stick. There's a body in front of the Black Ice body and one in between the net.
Anton Chavero's going to go 1-on-3 here. He sees the forward Schaubel. He'll skate around the back of the net. Doesn't force a play. Moves over to the far wall. He's got three guys on, and puck comes up the boards. Cadiz runs into DiMartino, but the puck goes to Pascali. Into his offensive zone, 2-on-2. Pascali drops it for Schaubel. Tries to get a shot, but it rolled on him. Now back to Kozlo. Kozlo, a wrist shot. Deflected in front. They score!
That's the bounce they needed, and they were only going to get it by a bounce.
How about this? Kozlo with the tally.
That was super unlucky. I mean, Joaquin's in great position. It just goes off the shin guard right in the net. It feels terrible, but he's in the right play. There's nothing he can do about it.
They're fixing the crease down TNT's net. Hey, we said they were keeping it simple. They got it to the front of the goal, went off the backside of a Rink Rat player, but still goes into the net. Maybe that's going to how you're going to have to beat TNT.
And Georgie, look what's happening right now. What's going on in TNT's end again?
No coincidence, says PJ Cavaya.
No, he just knows what he's doing. He's a smart guy, and he's doing all he can for his team to win.
Yeah, I see him. He's continually doing it. Abby and Olivia Weiss, just got to give a shout out. Aaron asked me to do that, so got to give Dad says hello. Dad's down by one, but hopefully they can get one. Uh-oh.
Eitan Chavira gets a break into the zone. Back over, but they score!
Listen to me, PJ, why did that happen?
Great forecheck by Eitan. He was all over the puck. Sorry, by Junior. Junior was on the puck. Eitan picked it up.
Okay, but before the faceoff even happened, who had the momentum?
Junior.
Black Ice, sorry.
What happened after that goal?
TNT killed time.
There you go. The momentum was gone.
He was trying to prove you right, and you weren't getting what he was saying.
didn't catch it there, eh? Still a rookie at this.
No, but that was a great point. He proved you right. The Martino wrist shot, it goes higher.
That's what TNT does, though, I'm telling you.
Another huge goal.
PJ, that's what I was talking about, and you brought it up. Man.
Black Ice was literally at the faceoff dot for like 30 seconds just waiting for the ref to drop it. TNT's killing time, cleaning the crease. He knows what he's doing. That's exactly what he needed to do.
Here's Eisenhower. George said he was going to be an important person in this game. Hasn't played much. He's out there now looking to make an impact.
But that's why. He's given the guys a rest for the last 5 minutes, I guess. But he's got it. Here's his shift to make a difference.
They give Kozlo a shift for the first time in a while, and he scored. Now DiMartino into the far circle, backhand shot, and a glove save made by Tartaglione. He's in the Black Ice's head right now.
Listen, just playing unreal.
The only goal to beat him was off of his own defenseman.
And let's talk about Junior Cadiz also, the game he's having.
Oh my.
Just give him the Jordan Wood
kids,
watch now.
The kid's still got it. What everyone else says, he's still got it.
Just give him the Jordan Wood watch right now for the MVP. That's what you receive here in the Pro Division.
Let's not speak too soon here, boys.
If it ends right now.
Especially when he's black
at all. I would never do that. There's 5 minutes left in this game.
Black Ice is, I think, going to have to pressure a little bit more here, coming, obviously, with 5 minutes left. But that can expose them as well.
Listen, but here's the thing. Right now,
Perella checked like that.
And Perella's got to be stronger than that. You can't lose the puck there when you have possession. And now he's just running around.
Draft far side. Did not get the shot away. Nice poke there from Matt Barry.
You've got to find a man and find him soon. He looks lost right now.
Gerger wrist shot. That one goes over top of the net. TNT didn't see that one either. Matt Barry, nice poke to get it behind the net with two Black Ice defenders on him.
See, and that's the difference in a man-to-man system like this. You get one guy that's lost and your whole system is done.
John Chavo down the right wing side, waiting, looking, goes to the back door. How did TNT save that?
Hey, Kraft took a slash at the bat of TNT. Crafty, even though he's young, he's a veteran too. He knew exactly what he was doing. Matt Barry got away from that.
What a play from
Barry. A little bit of luck, a little bit of skill. Tartaglione makes a big save.
Hey, Garrett Ross, there's three guys back in the zone. This is one you can just throw it back. But
he just got tied up so quick. That was a good job by the Black Ice. John Chavo.
Pass going over to Rink Rat bench, boys.
Pascali. Centers it. Matt Gerger's there. He shoots it. Scores!
Wow. I missed it. Of course, I'm walking to the other bench, and I miss it.
Huge goal by Black Ice.
This is the one time that poke check for Tartaglione worked against him, because he had the poke check ready, and the puck went 5-4.
Going to Black Ice's bench now. Matt Gerger got the goal?
Yes.
Yeah, he squeaked in as the third guy and just kind of slid it 5-4.
He was so upset on that last faceoff with Cadiz.
Here comes Pascali in. Tried to play in front. It was blocked. Joaquin Chavira.
And now guess who's out? It's Joaquin, Eitan, and Junior.
These are the boys you need here.
Yeah. And I was just about to say before I left the bench, Black Ice needed to take advantage of that last line that was out because they looked lost at times.
Long feed up for Eton. It missed. Goes by the net. Machinsky's out of the goal. Cadiz forced into the third round of the far wall. Matt Gerger with it.
Three on
right
two
side,
there.
Coslow. Great break up there by Mayhew. Now it's up for Eton Chavera. Has it in his skates. Gives it to Cadiz.
This is a scary sight when he comes in.
Cadiz, wrist shot. He just missed it. Goes in behind the goal. And Cadiz lets it sit on the back of the net. 3:01 left in the second period. His face-off should come to center.
Have any teams used their timeout here? I don't think so, right?
Neither one used
it. Yeah, so Rink Rat's obviously going to use theirs because I think they're getting a little fatigued.
But no, it's Black Ice using it.
All right, well, that just benefits Rink Rat.
Well, eventually they're going to get a goalie pull, George.
Duke, PJ, does this line play the last 3 minutes?
I think they need to throw out Haji, too, at some point.
Right, but I think Rink Rat also has a timeout left.
You're right, and the thing is, for me, the way that they're playing, you can trust Barry and Rossi up top. These guys have been playing really good in this game, and defensively, they've been reliable.
So I think
you can rotate those two lines of forwards and then throw, for me, it's Mayhew, Joaquin, and Haji.
Say that one more time, PJ.
Mayhew, Joaquin, and Haji on D. Rotate the three.
Okay, hey, go for a minute 30, take your time out, rest. Go for the other minute 30.
Exactly.
They're trying to put it together on the plan if they do pull Machinsky.
So when they pull him, obviously, you know, Rink Rat will go to a box, and they just got to block shots at this point and just sell out.
Sell out, that's it.
As I like to say, gentlemen, buckle your seatbelts. We got a one-goal hockey game with 3:01 left.
Watch for another TNT delay in there, too, at some point.
Guys, what I do want to see after this game, maybe, is to ask the guys in the truck, standing right next to you, ask those guys if we can get a replay of the first goal that was counted for Rink Rat.
Well, you can go back and look at it on the live stream. Just go hit the live button and go back.
All right.
You won't be able to get it quickly. Just have to go do a bunch of things. So. Matt Gerger leaves it for DiMartino.
I'll have to come up and turn the live stream then somehow.
PJ DiMartino into his offensive zone. Rink Rat, back. Trying to defend this one goal lead. One shot away is Black Ice. Pascali takes it. That one goes wide of the goal.
They're passive now. Rink Rat's passive now. They're not.
Martino Rister.
They've played this kind of D though all game long. They're just waiting for Black Ice to like try to attack them.
But they usually get to open to loose pucks and they're not right now.
Like this.
Right.
Cadiz has Chavo on it. Oh, a bad step. Cadiz on a breakaway. Shoots it! Scores!
That's a hat trick for Junior.
The hat trick for Junior Cadiz. 2:12 left in the second. Rink Rat leads by two.
He came to play today.
That is huge.
And the fact that he fought off the first guy, Gerger, he slips. Okay, it happens. But Junior makes the right play, goes right around him, patiently waits for Machinsky to go down, and just goes bar.
He waited for Chavo to come and hit him, and when he did, it pushed him forward, which fooled Gerger. So he lost his footing, and then he walked around him and went top shelf.
And I think Gerger just slipped. Did he fool? Down here, it just looked like he fell.
He definitely just slipped, yeah.
Yeah.
Extra attacker on for Black Ice. They need two now. This game is not over yet.
Goalie pulled, 150.
Chavo for Kraft to DiMartino. To the near side, Tiefenworth.
Junior Cadiz, has he not surprised you guys defensively today?
He plays this way, though. That's what people don't realize, is he does this
John
all the Chavo time.
John Chavo to the near side. It's blocked. Pops up in the air.
And who's on the rink? Corey Hodge.
Of course. You have to have him out the front.
DiMartino for Chavo. Chavo shoots.
They're not getting shot
quick enough.
It's
the helmet of Tartaglione.
There's no one-timers at all coming from Black Ice.
DiMartino to Chavo. Chavo to DiMartino. Backhand pass for Chavo. DiMartino again. He winds. He fires. That one goes just wide. Race for the loose puck on the near side. Cadiz gets there. They're not getting that.
He gets upended.
Puck goes to the far side. We're down to the final minute. Tiefenworth, the wrist shot. Saved by Tartaglione. And he gets the whistle.
Oh, Tommy's going to get one.
He needs to relax.
No, he's getting one now. Goalie's going. He's going to get one. That's his fault. You got to keep your cool at that point. You have to.
Yeah,
now you're going to get a power play. 5-on-3, give it to Black Ice with a minute left. You kidding me?
And someone from the Rink has to serve it. That's huge, too.
Well, now Joaquin can jump, so it's going to be Cadiz. You call your timeout now if you are Rink rat. You use it. If I'm a referee, I'm making him burn it.
Well, no, you can't with the sweat, I guess.
It looks like also on the bench here next to you, Georgie, that a couple of guys are doing slashing motions like he slashed it before Tommy freaked out on him.
Yeah, it doesn't
which
matter.
Maybe he did.
It doesn't matter, but Tommy still can't do that.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
It's a minute and a half, and especially
made
it
easy
sounds
on the ref.
Bad.
Made
it sounds
easy.
Bad, but you're down by two. I mean, you're up by two. What's the need?
Yeah, you need to see discipline, especially with a minute left in this type of game.
Wow.
Face off, won by Black Ice.
53, Treft.
DiMartino into the zone. A 5-on-3 long range wrister blockered away by Tartaglioni, who's exhausted in the net. Right point, DiMartino. Down to Tiefenwerth, shot. Tartaglioni fights it off. Tiefenwerth out to the point. DiMartino, wrist shot blocked by Hodge. 34 seconds left. Chavo out high. DiMartino back to Chavo. He shoots.
Hodge
gets up by Hodge. Graft in front. It bounces over to the near side. Cadiz tries to get to it. Doesn't poke it up the wall. Tiefenwerth near side circle. Waits. Looks to the front. Shoots.
Oh, they got one.
19.2 seconds left, and it's a 4-3 hockey game. Rink rat might call their timeout here. Cadiz, Hodge, Joaquin are gassed.
Face-off, Jeff, PJ, biggest face-off of the entire tourney.
And look at TNT in the corner.
He's got to call it. He's got to burn it.
Yeah, you
got
to burn it. You got to use your timeout now for him. He's exhausted. And he was screened on that goal, too. There's no way he was seeing that.
19.2 seconds left in the second period. $25,000 on the line. And that's a 4-3. Rat lead. If you'd have told me we'd have a 4-3 lead late, we'd have some exciting goals, I would have been amped up. Now that I've seen it, I'm even more amped up.
This is what we all expected, man. This is it.
We wanted a good game, and we got a thriller, and it's not over yet. Black Ice has the firepower to do this. Have you ever seen a center ice face-off so important?
And also, Black Ice has pulled their goalie. So they're leaving Machinsky out for this face-off.
I said it before, I'll say it again. Buckle your seatbelts. Here we go. $25,000 on the line. Rink rat holding a one-goal lead. Garrett Ross loses the draw to Pascali. DiMartino to the far side for Chavo. Down low. Kraft waits. Dances backhand off the side of the net. 10 seconds left. They try to get it out front. It's in the crease. Tartaglioni gets the save and the whistle. 6 seconds left. Like a rugby scrum in front of the net.
That is exactly what Rink rat needs to do. They are laying it all out there right now.
I am gassed.
Tommy is gassed.
I'm like Tommy Tartaglioni. I just ran to the office.
And now we talked about
batteries for my headphones. And I couldn't find them. So I'm hoping I last through the end of the game.
We talked about huge face-offs, Georgie. Here's another one.
Oh, man.
Eitan Chavera takes it against Pascali. You're winning to the corner.
If one of them could sign Cangelosi for 2 seconds, they do it.
Tiefenwerth on the near side, trying to inch his way into the circle. Here we go. Eitan Chavera, mano a mano with Billy Pascali. Big tie up off the draw. It's one back to the point. 2 seconds left. DiMartino turns, fires to the front of the net, shot. It goes wide, and Team Rink rat. The Cinderella
wow.
story.
Wow.
It's your 2018 Pama Pro Invitational Champions with a 4-3 victory over Mission Black Ice.
What a game.
Wow.
What a game.
Would you have thought that this would happen?
Georgie, how close was that last chance there? You had a good angle.
I don't think it had a chance to go over the line before the buzzer sounded. It was extremely close. Tyler Kraft just missed it, but it didn't have a chance to go in before the buzzer. I looked up and it was .2 before it even got to Crafty. So, hey, let's stay on here. Tell him to get the camera down here.
He's got it. He's got it for you, George. Got the best camera crew.
We're going over here.
Mr. Video Online doing a phenomenal job all week.
Congrats to Team Rink. They gutted this one out.
Hey, we're right here. Listen, we talked about Corey Hodge the entire game. Probably about three block shots on that last shift. Corey, we called you the most underrated player in this division. Corey, tell me how you're feeling right now after this game.
I mean, since I started playing pro, that's what you want to do. It's freaking unbelievable. It's nothing. It's awesome. I can't even believe it. It's like a little dream.
Corey, go ahead and shake hands, man. I'll let you go ahead. Guys, I'm going to grab Tommy Tartaglione real quick.
Don't
up
you
here,
love
too.
That, guys? Don't you love when someone is so happy they're speechless?
He was actually speechless.
No, he couldn't say anything. I'm going to grab Tommy T. Tell him to get
the,
to me on the bench.
This is the Stanley Cup of
keep Florida. That microphone guy, away. It's probably going to get some sweat on
these guys dead right now. My microphone.
Don't
I
ruin
just
my
touched,
mic. That's my
I
mic.
I just touched his jersey, and I'm soaked right now.
The glads will be rattled.
Yo,
if
Tommy
you
T.
ruin that mic.
Just tell me your feeling right now, brother.
Complete elation. Tours. 10 years ago, now I'm 30, to get a chance to play in a final and to play good is just an incredible feeling.
Tommy Tartaglione, you guys went through the round robin. Normal play, not bad play or anything like that, but these last two games, you stole games for your team. Just walk me through the last two games and what you guys talked about coming into these games.
Well, the message from game one was, if we limit their opportunities to the outside, I'm gonna make the saves, and the message was, we're preparing for a championship game. And fuck. Showed through in the semis, we were ready to go, I was ready to go, and we battled through.
Tommy Tartaglione, his team is $25,000 richer. Tommy, congratulations, man. You deserve it. Yeah, a lot of diapers, man, I hear you.
Well, we do apologize for the inappropriate language. I'm not blaming the guy, because he is on cloud nine right now.
The kid's coming down here, grabbing Ethan and Joaquin right here. The brothers Shavira, boys, just tell me how you're feeling right now.
Words can't describe how we're feeling right now. Everyone knows our story, and just good to be back, be able to build another good program, and wouldn't have had a better way to do it, my brother.
Ethan.
Oh, man. Underdogs. I didn't think I was going to come back to the sport, and brother brought me back, so we need to start playing again.
Yo, how special is it? Because I've never had the experience. How special is it to win something like that with your brother?
Words can't describe it. I mean, we won NARS back in 2006, and that was unreal. We were young kids back then, and this is just unbelievable. The talent of hockey that's now, and all these kids that are playing pros and college hockey, just the talent that's out here, it's unbelievable to put a good team together and to come out with a win like this.
You know, to come out here, you know, everybody's looking at it. It's not a secret. The top two favorites are Snipers and Black Ice. How do you prepare going into a game like that as the underdogs all the time?
Well, somebody told us, they said, you have nothing to lose, just go out there and give it all you got. First of all, you know, they're the best team around, and we said, if we can just match their speed, match their game, and try to control the puck, which we did the first period, we got in their heads. We scored first, we scored second.
Hey, George.
The momentum just kept it going. So.
That was huge, guys. Go celebrate with your team. We'll talk after the game. Good job, boy.
George, I was going to ask him how much it feels for them to do this when they were the underdog. No one picked them before the tournament.
I just did. That was my last question. I just did.
If you asked 150 people, like, guys,
were you not listening to my interview?
I was. If you asked 150 people, guys, no one was going to pick Rink Rat. Some of the Rink Rat players might not have picked them. That was awesome.
Yeah, this has got to be incredible for them right now.
Yeah, and they come in as underdogs. You know, like you just said, Trev, nobody came in thinking anybody was making it to the finals other than Black Ice and Snipers. You know what I mean? Did you, PJ, even playing for the Snipers, did you think it'd be any different?
No, truthfully, it's funny because someone mentioned to me, I don't know who it was, mentioned to me earlier, they're like, I just want to see a new team win this tournament, you know, and they got it. Rink Rat deserves it. Hats off to them. And another awesome game by Junior Cadiz. He was the catalyst in this game.
Trefty, be honest. Did you think any other team was going to win either than those two?
I thought this year, yes, would be a year just because they were so favored and they've done it before. I still expected Black Ice Snipers to be there, but I said I wouldn't be surprised if someone else does. But I certainly didn't think it was going to be Rink Rat. I thought RPD maybe. I thought Pama maybe, but that was it.
They kind of just swooped in and took care of business.
And they did it quietly, too. They even got the 4 seed, and still no one picked.
Right.
No one picked him in the first game.
Yeah, that is right. That is right.
It's like the LA Kings when they made the playoffs that one year and they won, and they were the 8 seed and they just ran through everybody.
Where's Junior? I'm down here with Junior Cadiz. Junior. Hat trick in this game, my friend.
you had to respond. After Black Eyes scored to get back into the game, you responded again. You guys just never gave up, and it was resiliency throughout the game, kept the lead the entire game. Talk to me about this team.
It's crazy, man. It's one of those teams where we just came together as a tournament. The next game and the next game, we got better and better, and we never gave up out there, and it paid off. People were eating cogs and sacrificing bodies, and camping up and eating IVs, and it was worth it.
Talk to me about that goal that happened right after Black Eyes made it 2-1, and then you guys, I think it was you and Ethan, came in on 2-on-1. Just walk me through that goal.
I think they made a pass back to one of the defensemen, and I think I tied him up, and it hit a skate, I believe, and then Ethan took it and gave me a good back row pass, and I had a very...
Well, Junior, congratulations, buddy. Your team, $25,000 richer. Congrats, man. That's Junior PD, one of the best players in the world, guys. Gonna send it back up to you guys.
PJ, you've been here before. You've won this tournament. What does it mean? Because we can all look at it and say, oh, the Stanley Cup is the Mecca of hockey, but for roller hockey, this is your what you want to win.
This is the pinnacle of the sport. Everybody in the sport wants to win this tournament. And hats off to Rink Grad. They did a great job today. All throughout the tournament, like you said, they were underdogs, and they come into the 4 seed, still underdogs. Come in the 7, still underdogs, and they squeak out in the final win. Great game against Black Eyes, very exciting game to watch.
George, see if you can get head coach Dan Maxwell. You talked to him before the game, and all the stuff that he said, they did perfectly.
And here we go, the selfless guy getting his award that he rightfully deserves.
Cal O'Reilly, he's won all sorts of things. Ice hockey in here, his roller hockey debut.
And solid start to the roller career, hey?
We're doing the award ceremony now. Garrett Ross gets his gold medal. Much deserved gold medal. Ross scored some big goals in this tournament. Joaquin, I mean, he was a big part of putting this team together. And PJ, what does this mean for the sport too? Because now teams can look at it and go, I can win.
Yeah.
Rinkrat did it. I can do it.
They put together a great game plan against a great team, and they came out on top. And if they can do it, I mean, not saying that it's possible for everybody, but hey, it's available. And it's not going to be the same teams that win it over and over. Upsets do happen, and they're living proof.
Hey guys, Cal O'Reilly here. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm from Buffalo, so I'm pretty mad I didn't get to meet you guys in Buffalo, but I get to meet you now. Walk me through your roller debut. What was this tournament like for you, Cal?
What an experience. Seeing the talent of some of these players and how fast they want to play. It's like they're on skates. I was very impressed. I knew a little bit coming in, but not much. And it was a lot harder than I expected. It was a big learning curve, but I had a lot of fun. The guys were great with me, you know, trying to get me a couple goals some of the games. And it was just cool to be a part of it.
Can you walk me through the selfless act you had? We see you didn't play in the championship, but walk me through that. What was your mindset there?
Well, I just told Dan, I said, listen, I don't want to be out there. You know, I feel like I'm a liability. And I don't feel comfortable. I don't want to slow these guys down. They're going so well. And these are big games. So just I'm fine sitting on the bench. You guys just roll your guys that are going. And he said, he didn't come to me and say, I
said, I got to get him. Let the guys go. So, well. What a professional. Last question. Now that you've come over the roller side for a little bit, are you a roller guy now also?
I'm definitely a fan, and I would love to get better at it. And help a little bit more. So I definitely am for sure.
Cal, that's awesome. So we'll see you around the roller rinks, buddy. Cal O'Reilly, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll give it back to you upstairs while you have the award ceremony.
PJ, any final thoughts?
Junior's going home with a really nice watch.
Yeah. Junior Keys gets the MVP.
Rightfully so.
That's an unbelievable performance from him. He gets a hat trick and an assist. A 4-3 win. Can't get much better than that.
Kid came to play.
When you put MVP.
And let's not forget about Tommy in net too. He just did a great job. Yeah. The first goal goes off a shin guard on his own team. And then the next two, they were good goals. But he was the backbone that this team needed.
I think it's about that time, guys. Here it is.
And rightfully so, Joaquin gets the first touch.
Joaquin Chavera grabs the trophy, and Rinkrat can celebrate
guys, I'm heading back upstairs. But what a sight, guys. I mean, no matter what team wins, when you get to see something like this and the accolades they get and the joy of victory, guys, it's just wonderful to see that. Grown men. A grown man down here, Tommy Tartaglione, crying. A grown man because of what a team has done throughout a weekend.
I'm actually getting goosebumps. Stuff. Yeah, I have goosebumps. That was cool.
Crazy, man.
And it's hot crazy. Here. And I got some chills.
I'm coming back upstairs, boys.
But nonetheless,
congrats to Team Rink Rat.
Congratulations, Team Rink Rat. Congratulations to the sponsor, Rink Rat. Congratulations to all those players that win the Mecca of roller hockey. They have roller hockey support.
You know, they always say you win some, you lose some. Black Ice has won tons of tournaments.
They'll be back.
Snipers have won tons of tournaments, but Rink Rat, maybe this was their year, they deserved it.
So, for George Brown, PJ Cavaya, Dennis Joseph, who helped us throughout the playoffs, I'm Chris Trept. Congratulations to Team Rink Rat, who was $25,000 richer in the 2018 Pama Pro Champions. And thank you for watching the home for State Wars 14 here in St. Peter's, Missouri, SWHY.